talk a bit more about the three stages of closing the vocal glottis, the space between the vocal cords exercise. Now, in my previous video, I showed how to yawn first, then do with the yawn, stop the sound, just yawn and do the opening closing of the vocal cords. And then the third stage was that I open and close the vocal cords while, you know, producing a sound. It's important to understand that these things add on top of one another. So the first thing is just to really feel what it feels like to produce this open yawn sound, as open and as yawned as you possibly can. Right? The second stage is the feeling that you keep that yawn, because the first one is just to for you to check, okay, how wide can I actually make everything, right? How big can I actually feel? How relaxed and open can I actually, feel with that sound? And then you keep that feeling in the second stage. That feeling of, right? You hold it again, and then you open and close the glottis without a sound, so that you understand in the second step the feeling, what it feels like to close your glottis, even though your throat and everything is very, very extremely wide, right? And then you remember that feeling, what it feels like to do that, and then you do the third stage, which is the same thing, just with the sound. So they build on top of each other.
First, the feeling of yawning and wideness, and secondly,
oh, that was good. Secondly, you keep that feeling, and you just practice how that feels to keep that feeling and close and open the rima glottidis. And then the third stage, you do the same thing. You hold that feeling of wideness and open yawning sound and do it with this sound. I do that in these stages that kind of like build on top of one another, because it's easier to go from simple to complex, right? You don't want to start complex and then you can't control anything. You want to start very simple and then you want to go to complex and slowly add and add and add. Also important to mention that it's with supported head voice, not with aspired. If you don't know what I mean when I say supported head voice or aspired head voice, I will explain that in detail in this video. I am starting this exercise with supported head voice. So not just aspired, I support already. And the yawn is supported, holding the air in the lungs. Right, I don't go, I go, it is as wide and open as I can, but also I hold the rib cage as open as I can, so that I don't have to totally switch between closing and opening. Oh, now I have to hold the air back, now I can let it out, now I have to hold it back. No, I hold the air back in my lungs the entire time, and then I just open and close, but there's no more or less air pressure behind my vocalise. All right. Yeah, so that just as a little add-on for you to understand better what I do when I close and open the glottidis, the rima glottidis, the space between the vocal cords.